Very warm and pleasant good morning to all my dear students of class 3. So today we will continue with the chapter division that we were doing that day. I hope you all have completed your homework. Whatever I have given, I had asked you to do in the book itself. Okay, so today we are going to do division without remainder and division with remainder. Okay, so before getting started, let me teach you some basic terms in division. Okay, so if, for example, if I tell you to divide 56 divided by 7, okay, so you can divide straight away like this also. 56 divided by 7, you can write your answer directly like this also. 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 7 threes are 21, 7 fours are 28, 7 fives are 35, 7 sixes are 42, 7 sevens are 49, 7 eights are 56. You get your answer as 8. But this is not the correct way of doing division. Okay, you have to do division like this. Okay, this is your division sign. Did you get it? So here we will write this 7 and 56. Okay, so 7 is your what? This 7 is your, the number which we write here, it is your divisor. D-I-V-I-S-O-R. This is your divisor. Okay, then the number which you write here, what is this? This is your dividend. D-I-V-I-D-E-N-D. It is your dividend. Okay, and 7, 8's are 56. And this is your quotient. Q-U-O-T-I-E-N-T. Okay, then we will minus this. 6 minus 6, 0. 5 minus 5, 0. Here, remainder is 0. Whatever we get here, that is your remainder. So, these are the four basic terms which you should know in your division. Okay? The number which we, the number through which we divide, that is known as your divisor. Then the number which we divide, that is your dividend. Then the answer we get, that is a quotient, and whatever remaining remains, that is your remainder. Here there is no remainder. In further sums, we will get sums with remainder also. Okay, whatever number zero cannot be counted as a remainder. This is not a remainder, but just for an example, I'm saying the number whatever is left over here, that is known as remainder. So keep these four terms in your mind: divisor, dividend, quotient, and remainder. Okay, so these are the four basic terms in your division. So let's get started with the sum. We will do division without remainder first. Then we will do division with remainder. Okay, so now let's do some exercise in division without remainder. Okay, I hope you all have learned a table. I've asked you many times to learn the tables. Okay, because without table you cannot do division. You cannot do maths only without division. Not only division, okay? So it's very necessary to learn tables. You still have time. Those who have not learned your table, please learn it fast. Okay, so now let's do the exercise. It's very easy, no? It's very easy. So you have to divide 24 by 6. Okay, now tell me the table of 6. 6 ones are 6, 6 twos, and you have to stop when 24 comes, okay? 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 6 threes are 18, 6 fours are 24. 6 fours are 24, and you will minus this. 4 minus 4 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0. So what is the answer? Your answer is 4. Okay, you got it. There is no remainder here because we are doing sums without remainder. Then let's move on to the next sum. Tell me the table of 6 again. 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 6 threes are 18, 6 fours are 24, 6 fives are 30. Yes, 6 fives are 30. Then we divide, then we minus, then this becomes 0, 0. And your answer is 5. Okay, got it? So now let's do the next sum. So 7, tell me the table of 7. 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 7 threes are 21, 7 fours are 28, 7 fives are 35, 7 sixes are 42, 7 sevens are 49. You have to stop when 49 comes, right? So, how many times 7 is 49? 7 sevens are 49. Okay, then we minus here 0 and this becomes 0. So your answer is 7. Okay, move on to the last sum now. Okay, tell me the table of 9. 9 ones are 9, 9 twos are 18, 9 threes are 27, 9 fours are 36, 9 fives are 45, 9 sixes are 54, 9 sevens are 63, 9 eights are 72, 9 nines are 81. 9 nines are is 81. Okay, so those who have not learned a table, please learn it, because you cannot do division without tables. Okay, you cannot do division without your multiplication table. So please learn your tables. Okay, those who have not learned. So these are your sums, some few examples of division without remainder. Now we will do division with remainder. Okay, let's move forward. Sums with division with remainder. Okay, a number always cannot be divided exactly by the other number. Okay, there we get whatever number that has left out, they are known as remainder. I have taught you the four terms in your division: dividend, divisor, quotient and remainder. Okay, so keep that in mind. A number always cannot be exactly divided by the other number. Okay, so whatever remaining we get, that is known as remainder. So here we are going to do similar sums, division with remainder. Okay, so let's do the first sum. Tell me the table of 3. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12. When I say 3 4s are 12, the number it exceeds. Okay, so we have to write number which comes before 10. Okay, we cannot write number that exceeds 10. Okay, so we have to stop when 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9. So 9 is smaller than 10. So we have to stop there. Why? Because we cannot write 12. That will be wrong. We cannot write bigger number down. Okay, we have to write one number smaller. So 3 1 is 3, 3 2 is 6, 3 3 is 9. Okay, so 9 minus 10 minus 9 is, what is 9 minus 10? What comes after 9? What comes after 9? 10. So your remainder is 1. So your answer will be, quotient is 3 and your remainder is 1. Okay, so quotient is 3 and remainder is 1. And in this division with remainder, you can check your answers also, whether your answers are correct or not. Okay, 3 3s are 9. So whatever quotient you have got, you have to multiply it with the dividend, then you add with the remainder. Okay, 3 3s are 9, 9 plus 1 is 10. And you have to get this divisor. Okay, so you will get your answer. Okay, so now let's move forward. Further now, tell me the table of 8. 8 1s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 8 3s are 24. So when I say 8 3s are 24, the number it exceeds. So what we have to write? 8 2s are 8 1s are 8, 8 2s are 16. Yes, you will write 8 2s are 16. Then you will minus here. So we cannot minus 0 from 6. So what we'll do here again, we will borrow. So here it will be left 1 and this will become 10. So you'll keep 10 in your mind and start counting after 6. 7, 8, 9 and 10. So what is the remaining answer? 4. So 1 minus 1 is 0. So your answer is, your quotient is 2 and your remainder is 4. Okay, so let's quickly check also. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10. 2 6 are 12, 2 7 are 14, 2 8 are 16. 16 plus 4, 17, 18, 19 and 20. So you got your answer correct. Okay, so now let's do the third sum now. Tell me the table of 4. 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 4 3s are 12, 4 4s are 16, 4 5s are 20, 4 6 are 24, 4 7s are 28, 4 8s are 32. 4 8, you can write 4 is a 4 9s is 36. So we cannot write 36. So we have to write 4 8s are 32. Then you have to minus. 2 minus 3 minus 2 is 1. So your answer will be, here it is 0. Your answer will be, quotient is 8 and your remainder is 1. So 8 4s are 8 1 is 8, 8 2 is 16, 8 3 is 24, 8 4 is 32, 32 plus 1 is 33. So you got your answer. This way you can check your answers also. This is your quick way to check your answer so that you don't lose your marks in your exams. Okay. So now let's move to the last sum now. Six, tell me the table of 6. 6 1s are 6, 6 2s are 12, 6 3s are 18, 6 4s are 24, 6 5s are 30, 6 6s are 36, 6 7s are 42, 6 8s are 48. Can we write 6 8s are 48? No, because it is exceeding the number. Okay, the number is bigger than 47 is smaller than 48. So we cannot write. So what we'll write? 6 1s are 6, 6 2s are 12, 6 3s are 18, 6 4s are 24, 6 5s are 30, 6 6s are 36, 6 7s are 42. We have to write 6 7s are 42. We cannot exceed the number because we cannot write bigger number down. Okay. So we will minus 7 from 2. Then you will keep 7 in your mind. Then start counting after 2. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And you get 5 here. 4 minus 4 is 0. So your answer is, your quotient is 7 and your remainder is 5. Now 7 1s are 7, 7 2s are 14, 7 3s are 21, 7 4s are 28, 7 5s are 35, 7 6s are 42. 42 plus 5, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47. So your answer is absolutely correct. So this way you can check your answers. Okay? So this way you will not lose your marks. So I hope you got the trick. Now I hope you got all the sums now. You can do, if I send you some homework in your maths, can you do it now? Yes. And those who have not learned your multiplication table, please learn your tables. Because you might have seen here while I was teaching, those who were knowing the table, they were answering with me only. They were with me. But those who are not knowing table, it will be very difficult for you to solve problems in maths. Okay. So learn your multiplication table now. Oh, those who have not learned, you still have time, you learn it. After learning only, you will do your division. Okay, so make it a habit of learning table every day, one table. At least learn table till 9. Okay? So that's all for today, my dear students. I hope you got all this, whatever I have taught you now. I'll send you some sums as a homework. You will do it in your notebook neatly and clearly. Okay? Until then, stay at home, stay safe. See you all in the next class. We will continue with the same chapter. Have a good day, my dear students.